Are digital cameras becoming more lifeless? That is the question today. And the answer is totally yes. It seems like everything being released is higher megapixel count and also sharper, sharper, sharper. We're diving deeper and closer into the files, checking them out. And I think we're forgetting something. I think there are certain cameras and lens combos that have a certain flavor or feel. And I think it's great when you find, the combo that resonates with you and you stick with it. Like one example for me is I love portraits. It's not very common, but in the 50 millimeter focal range, because I shoot mostly kids and teens and I like to show a little bit of the environment. And I kind of like that look. It works for me. I've tried 85, I've gone 135, and those are fine, but I always go back to 50. It's kind of like your favorite paintbrush. And I feel like a lot of the cameras, the newer cameras I've tried, are so, the images are kind of very good, but they're lacking in the analog feel. You know, the early Canon cameras, I'm looking through my old Canon 5D Mark II images, they had a filmic quality to them straight out of camera. If you threw, you know, the right vintage lens on there or an older lens like the 85 1.8, it kind of matched up with what your film was getting. And now these cameras are just hyper sharp. Even my Sony a7 III, which was my main work camera, I am like massaging those files, adding grain, adding curves to try to tone down their crazy sharpness. So high megapixels are great, don't get me wrong. You know, my favorite image is right outside in the hallway of New York, and that was taken with the GFX 100 megapixels. You don't need that many megapixels, but if you're printing and you're looking up that close, cityscape, landscape, sign me up for 45 megapixels, 50 megapixels. But shooting this Fujifilm 16 megapixel, little old used camera, this camera has more character than some of the higher megapixel cameras I've shot. You know, the images are still sharp here, but they have a little bit of, like the colors are off, just like when we shot film. It's not, you know, it's got, there's tones, you know, the images have tones to them. And Fujifilm, this is the X-Trans2 sensor. With the next sensor that came out after this, the X-Trans3, they fixed the colors. The colors are more color accurate and pleasing. And then the X-Trans4, which I'm filming this on right now, is sharper, clearer, more color punchy. But I feel that they lost something giving up this X-Trans2 sensor. This thing has like a filmic quality to it. I love the images I'm getting from this. And I'm gonna do a video on the X-Trans2 versus the X-Trans4 because I took images to compare the two, so stay tuned for that. But I just wanted to make this video sort of as like asking you guys, do you have a camera that maybe has character and then you have another one that doesn't have character? I feel that the camera lenses and cameras coming out are so sharp that it's shaping our photography. I'm not gonna call anyone out, but if you look through some of the modern portrait photographers, they're just like super smooth skin, sharp, sharp eyelashes, and clean images. They're just so sterile looking. And let me know if you feel the same way or if I'm crazy. I'm just spitballing here. But I think some of us are like in this crossroad of embracing new technology, but also we're still nostalgic and in love with a filmic quality that the first digital cameras had. And I suspect this is the reason why a lot of young photographers are gravitating towards analog and film shooting. They're getting something, you know, they're getting like a feel from those images that when you shoot your 50 megapixel super clean file, you don't get that feeling immediately. You have to create it in post. And so that's why I've been like so having so much fun shooting this little Fujifilm X70 and then diving into the old Canon files. I'm like, wow, the images used to look filmic and had a quality. You didn't really have to edit them that much. You know, part of the fun of shooting the X70 has been like, what is the camera going to do? What is the film going to do? As opposed to what am I going to do with the image after? And who knows, this may separate the photographers. The hyper sharp, the people who can't edit or massage the files to give them character, they just may be falling flat, those images. And real photographers and real artists can take these sterile, hyper well, you know, executed images and massage them into something. So it's like an interesting time. And I want to know what you guys think. What cameras do you have that have character? What lenses do you have that have character? Is it an age thing? Am I getting older? So I'm, you know, I still have a nostalgic feel for film and, you know, images that are a little softer. And the young generation wants hyper sharp. I don't know. I'm throwing this out there to you guys just to start the conversation. But it is interesting to see where this leads. What comes after 50 megapixels, 100 megapixels, and, you know, seeing every eyelash and every leaf vein? Do we need to go that sharp? Everyone agrees that you don't need a super high megapixel camera. But even the lower megapixel cameras' images, some of them are lifeless. So can we get life back into our cameras? All right, I'll see you guys next time.